You take the Lusus milk. Maybe this will calm that beast? Maybe. Now put it into there. Alright. The Big Book of Beasts recommends placing a skittish or aggressive Lusus' food somewhere accessible and then getting the heck out of the way. That's actually very helpful. Thank you, Big Book of Beasts. You dip a corner of the diagram in the milk, or at least you try. The paper actually curls up and away from the surface of the liquid. You aren't going to force it. Byers is lactose intolerant, you're pretty sure. How do we know? Though this stuff may not actually contain lactose. You know what? You're not going to overthink it. The rampaging beast out there might not like the weird smell. Where to it, you mean. Obviously you think it smells heavenly, and by it you mean the spice mix, not the milk. And by it that time you meant it the second time. Clear as a bell. It's probably already acidic enough, or wait, maybe it's basic? Whatever, it's gross milk, you don't want to stick a battery in there. You think maybe the milk on its own might be enough? You don't want to gild the monster lactated lily here. Oh. What about the pogs? These are pogs, not sogs. No. Spilling this precariously full bowl of nasty milk all over yourself while you tap dance in place doesn't seem like a great use of your resources, such as the resource of a body not covered in nasty milk. You could, of course, walk around with this bowl of milk on your head and not spill a drop. You're just that graceful. Not that you ever would, but you could. That'd kind of be a step backwards, wouldn't it? You pick a page at random and accidentally spend... yeah. Like that. You could have fixed this to the front of the fridge, but what if Dammek came back and thought you were making fun of him? Well, you would be, so that's a win. But this thing might be important. Better keep it close. That'd be kind of a step backwards... The alien fridge is probably pretty bland, but the food inside it would probably get more out of the spicing. Too bad for Dammek, because you're planning to keep it all to yourself. You once heard the battery... Yeah, and honestly, like if you read the first part of that in the human fridge on Earth, like if you're being really honest with yourself, you don't think it's a particularly good idea either way at the moment. Yeah, like I said, it doesn't really work. A lot of people think it does. Not even the no doubt astonishing technology powering this extraterrestrial frigidaire is capable of making pogs cool. These don't need refrigeration, which, considering they probably contain some kind of meat, is kind of weird, right? You're not sure if that's weird or not. Tonight's events have decalibrated your internal weirdness adjudicator. Adjudicator. Tap dancing at an alien's fridge because to hell with how today's been going so far, might as well get real weird with it. With the tragic theatrical grace of the endangered whooping crane, you avoid slipping in the exotic puzzle you're now standing in. Alright, what about this? It's really gross. Maybe you could clean it? Yeah, you definitely traveled to a strange alien world to deep clean this guy's kitchen. That's how you live your life, for sure. Yeah. The bowl of milk, despite recently being in the fridge, is already lukewarm. That's gross, but handy. It's gross in there. If you're going to be carrying this thing around, and for some reason you seem to have committed to that, you don't want to get a bunch of leftover bug food or whatever on it. What happens here? You black out for half a second and reawaken with no memory of the horrible thing you already just attempted. I thought it was a bug. You almost just attempted. You should always do most of your spicing during cooking, since the flavor is then suffused more evenly throughout the dish, and you can be more economical with your spices. None of this applies to microwaving, though. Lots of microwave? That would destroy both. If you don't really care about the microwave, but hey, you might need the batteries. The inside of the microwave looks pretty gross. The minimal increase in the treat's esculent caliber from heating it up would be offset by a skyrocketing sepsis saver. Pogs? I try the pogs? Sounds like a good way to start a fire. You think, you don't have a microwave in your kitchen, so you're not exactly sure what they do to cardboard. You also don't have any food in your kitchen, but that's not really relevant, just depressing. You're just really not eager to jostle anything in this gross kitchen, especially an open microwave. Isn't that, like, dangerous? Maybe not to bug boys. Fiery hot on the outside, but with a cold, untouched center, microwave food and ballerinas have more in common than you'd expect. Do I go up there? They seem to lead up to a curving hallway. And I could feed that, but can we go up here? Oh, yeah. God, there's so much here. What's that? Goes back. A hover pad. This really is the future. By which you mean this is an alien planet or something. Wait, is this the future? Looks like Dammek is pretty into guns. He resolved to be a little more cautious when solving his goofy paranoia puzzles. Also, if you ever, like, meet him in person. You pick up... Hey, isn't that another one of those tucked in the pages? Probably not, but why not find out? Another one of these tucked in the pages. Mm. Hey, that looks like some kind of book of animals. Byers, what do you... Oh, he's asleep. Why not dash over there and take a closer look? Books don't need batteries. These are not books. What the hell? Well, you think, this is an alien planet. Maybe you better take a closer look. Oh, wait, it's talking about books. Looks like it would be a good place to hide these stupid pogs, except it kind of looks interesting. Darn, you want to read it. There's some kind of error. There's nothing here to read. You don't know what that book is, but you kind of want to give the monster on the cover a treat. This one's in arm's reach. You can just grab it. No need for delicacy. Just pick up the book if you want. I can't. There's no book here. Wow, this is a lot of crap. This big messy pile of weapons and percussion instruments is really hampering your ability to use these stairs. Sheesh. What luck! A vet med kit, just like the one you forgot to bring along for the trip. Well, maybe. It could just as easily be some lame old normal med kit for non-veterinarians, but you're optimistic. Just plunge your hands into the pile of death, huh? You think you'll look around a bit for something here to assist you, like the hover thing? This bowl of milk could be the solution to your problem. The other problem, though? Not this one. This is a whole different problem. Could you use the bowl of Lusus milk to distract the deer cat while you... Maybe, like, you're not sure, do something with the vet med kit? There's a lot of various variables to consider. You haven't ironed out all the kinks out yet. With both of these close at hand, you'll be ready to treat any injured animals that cross your path. Even monsters. Okay, maybe not monsters. You prefer your patients to be a little calmer than that. Oh yeah, it looks like the beams from the portal may be blasted up through the floor, destroying half the stairs and knocking this lethal crap all over the place. All over the place, especially in your way, especially in that place in particular. What are the odds? Byers can't possibly move all that stuff by himself. There is not a single piece of this pile that he can lift so much as one single inch, probably. Probably. This place seems pretty rough and tumble, so you feel better knowing that if Byers were to hurt himself somehow, you have the instruments to treat him. Treating that thing's chronic case of force field disease may be your only hope of getting home, but these aren't the right tools to treat those serpents. Snakes. You meant to say snakes. This deadly stew of guns, drums, speakers, and guns is spicy enough. Risky move. For all you know, your spice mix could be lethal to the animals on this planet. One stray shake and all this specialized animal-saving gear becomes less than useless. There are what look to be some high-tech medical instruments in here, but you'll have to hope they run on their own power. Not that you've had a lot of luck in that department today. The power department, where things are on. There might be something in this pile of percussive death that needs batteries, but since the whole lethal mess is currently inert, you don't see a great reason to go powering it up. You don't know what good it'll do, but sure, why not? You put one single pog into the vet med kit. You thought these were the crummiest discs you'd ever see, and then you saw those symbols shaped like saw blades. Jeez, Dammek, everyone gets it. You're a bad boy. A very sensible idea. You put a pet treat in the med kit for safekeeping, and also because it's cute. You feel like you would have been afraid to do this earlier today, too worried about pets getting into the med kit. But now you feel like it's fine, especially since you're going to be holding onto this thing for the foreseeable future. Unless you're trying to get that crazy deer cat monster to come investigate this dangerous pile and then get hurt, not a lot of point. And of course you aren't trying to do that. Jeez, who do you think you're talking to here? Some delicate instruments in there. You don't want to jostle them too much. Your mind drifts to your old dreams. Professional vet by day, professional dancer by night. Or was it the only other way around? Or something else entirely? It feels like it's already been a very long time since you're in home, safe in your room, or playing in the yard with your dog and your brother. You guess for the time being, your dreams are the only place you'll be seeing them. Aw. Haha, this pile looks a little more volatile than the cardboard box variety you're used to. You think maybe your shoes should look for another way to solve it. Like one that isn't you standing next to a pile of probably loaded guns and stomping your feet a lot. You're graceful, but this is just incredibly dangerous. Between the pile of death and the pit of death, it's way too risky. Alright. Now we can get this. You think of all the possibilities for animal care held in this little kit. You kind of regretted not taking the one from your bedroom, but this more than makes up for that absurd blunder. Alright. Now this is the same. Yeah. Oh, terrible news. The pile of dangerous garbage seems to be past saving. Unless you can find some way to lift it to get the heck out of your way, that's the best treatment in your amateur professional opinion. Amateur professional opinion. These bands look pretty cool. Like, not exactly your thing, but pretty cool nonetheless. Okay. Looks like Dammek has speakers all over his house. You know, for a guy who's apparently obsessed with conspiracy and secrecy, he sure seems to be a kind of showy jackass. I looked at that, right? Yeah. Alright, so speakers. This is for treating sick beasts, not sick beats. Hefting this chunky slop up to that shelf is a recipe for disaster. Yeah, your diagram just doesn't seem to match this thing. The more of Dammek's tech you see, the more convinced you are. He flaps up there and then flaps right back down as if to say, yes, it's a cute little ledge for me to perch on, but there's no room. It's covered in speakers and trash, just like most of this room and a house. Wow. Ice cold, buyers, but you can't disagree. They're out of your spice and reach. What a shame. You had a lot of rhythm hopes on riding these turmeric waves, but your ship has sunk. R.I.P. the SS Spicy Speakers. No stand-up style speakers of any of these pogs on any of these pogs, although several do feature anthropomorphic boomboxes, their plastic faces contorted in aggression or perhaps in existential horror. Well, buck up, boomboxes. In this life, you either play the music or you dance to it. Otherwise, you're just a nobody. These speakers probably aren't alive. You've seen most of the house by now, and you're like 80% sure about this. They might have once been big weird bugs, but you can't rule that out. But at the very least, they're dead big weird bugs now. Nope, they're holding firm up there. You guess that this was kind of a jerk move in retrospect, trying to makes his speakers fall off the shelf. If he's actually at your house, you hope he's being a better involuntary guest than you. Yeah, right. I guess that guy is at our house. Huh. Now, there's supposed to be a game coming up in the future, well, after these four episodes. I forget what it's called, but, I think it's named after their town. Haunt Switch or something like that? In which you play as the troll. Damascus, whatever the hell his name is. Whoa, dancing to speakers that are specifically not playing music? That's pretty high concept. You're ready for Off-Broadway just as soon as you get back on Earth. A hover pad. This really is the future, by which you mean this is an alien planet or something. Wait, is this the future? Alright, I'm not gonna mess with it yet. The hover sled, does have nice antlers, but you're pretty sure it's not actually an alive animal. The bowl is already holding the milk pretty expertly. Transporting loose milk by way of hover beams sounds like playing with fire. Are the force field and the portal based on the same technology? You kind of doubt it. The hover pad seems to be less dependent on the serpent and music box aesthetic, plus the hover pad has not launched you across space against your will. It will only hover you across a much smaller amount of space with your permission. You assume. Did I do this? And this? Yeah. Byers doesn't really need any help hovering. He can fly, but he appreciates the offer in the extremely limited capacity to which he is able to comprehend it. It's got the same maybe-a-bug sheen that a lot of stuff in here has, but it's not a bug, you think. And bugs aren't food anyway. Jeez, this place is getting to you. It doesn't need pogs to serve as tiny little wheels. It's a hover pad. Boy, you sure feel silly about that Pogs as Wheel suggestion. You really put everything you had into that, and you know you came up short. It's fun to think of the hoverpad as a faithful steed, but ultimately it's just a machine. By hovering, it will be immune to your taps. There's a dreamy kind of logic to it, doesn't it? You don't need a hoverpad to defy gravity. I just want to look at this. We have this stuff, so I just want to look. With both of these close at hand, you'd be ready to treat any injured animals that cross your path, even monsters. Okay, maybe not monsters. You prefer your patients to be a little calmer than that. Okay, I just want to check downstairs real quick with the... You're somehow back here, above the room from before, the one you crawled out of the vent into. The hallway curved from all the way around the living room and back to here. Whoever designed this house is an actual, honest-to-goodness lunatic. Okay, I want to check around there with the pet med kit thing. It doesn't work. That would be a criminal waste of disinfectant. There's some rehydrating cellulose in the vet med kit, so you're all set. If any of the stuff in the fridge used to be animals, it's too late for you to do anything for them. Feed. We also need to get the hovercraft, too. Oh, look, he's by his statue. Oh, shrip, 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 shrip. You can hear the deer cat slurping the milk right on the other side. You would startle if you went through this way. Okay. Ascend. The time for action is now. Use the hovercraft. Hover pad. Sephiroth says this is his, but it looks like Dammek, has other ideas. Oh well. Dammek is in here. Now you can help Sephiroth with it and help Sephiroth by returning it. I found the hover pad. Hover sled? Whatever it's called. I got it. I can come save you. Excellent. Although I think I'm a little boxed in. Between the deer cat and this pile of guns and drums, I don't really have a clear path. Oh well, I'll figure it out. Well, the Tetrarch made some pretty excessive modifications to my hover pad that might be able to help. Yeah, the guy doesn't sound like he has a good sense of respect for boundaries or personal property. Oh, he hates it. Tetrarch Dammek says the concept of private property is a vehicle for exploitation and a tool by which the high bloods subjugate the low blood underclass. Well, I'm new here. I can't really comment, I guess. Anyway, it'll be back in your hands now, so problem solved. X. D. Okay, I'll give it a shot. Talk to you soon. Okay, I got it. Float like a hover pad, sting like a bee, or whatever. Let's not get carried away here. So this is the same as when I mess with it. You're not especially strong, but you think you could manage to carry a book without xenotechnological assistance. Even a big book. Also, you're pretty strong. You shouldn't be down on yourself like that. Did I read that? Yeah, I did. This vet medkit from another world is a lot like the one you accidentally left at home, but better. See, it's got all sorts of bandages, some disinfectant wipes, a pair of tweezers, some leather gloves, a spongy amoeba thing, some green water, a tube of mandible ointment, a set of black dice, a tiny skull. Alright, you really need to update your skill set, but the majority of these things are totally serviceable. Alright, let me run down there really quick. Actually, before I even do that... What's that? Why do these have all the same dorky symbol on them? Boys, you swear. They can stay right where they are, really. Why would you bother to clean up Dammek's clothes with the hover pad? It's a gross misuse of such amazing technology. Emphasis on gross. It'd be polite to put this back where you found it, if you weren't planning on holding on to it forever. Yeah, maybe if this were a diagram for a dang washing machine. Byers looks like he'd like to settle down in that pile of discarded boy clothes and just completely get his nest on, shredding and pooping to his gross little heart's content. Nasty Byers. Have some dignity. That's not going to do anything about the smell. Maybe they don't wash their clothes on this planet? That might just throw them away from when they've worn them for a while. Maybe. You slip a pog in the pile of clothes. Oh yes, advantage Joey. Somehow. Unless he likes pogs. It looks like they've already been nibbled on a bit. You guess that deer monster just gets the run of the place? The hardened mass of this smelly weirdo's clothes might actually make for a hard enough surface to tap on, but the idea of the crusty mass being broken up by your foot stomps, you may be tripping and falling into the pile of dirty clothes, is just really, really gross. Okay. Okay, if you were performing Gizmelly, just smelly. Okay, that joke was worse than the clothes. Let me check down there real quick. Now they have the hover thingy. You somehow found the discipline to resist floating a pile of dirty alien dishes over your head. The hover pad is already a technological marvel. You're not sure you can handle the concept of it also warming food unevenly. The fridge has like a jillion tubes connected to it. You're really not prepared to face the consequences that may spray out of those tubes if you yank the fridge away with the hover pad. Bug water juice boxes? Dammek buys them in bulk, apparently. Maybe he used the hover pad to bring it in, or maybe he's really strong. You don't know him, you couldn't say. Alright, back up. Just want to see all that. And I'm guessing we're supposed to use the hover pad on the garbage, or on to just move, I don't know. Cool. These scenes are a little quieter for some reason. If the Tetrox Lusus is upset, it might have got X hurt. Got X? Got 10? That's cute. Got 10. Anyway, I did see a whole lot of blood smeared up to a huge hole in the floor. Oh no. Well, it was brown, so it's pretty old? I'm not sure what you mean. The Tetrarch is a bronze blood. So that's either Dammek or is Lusus, and it's recent. Wait. Okay, you've been saying things about blood color a lot, but I've been assuming it was metaphorical? Are you saying members of your species literally have different colors of blood? Yeah, I'm a rust blood. Okay, that makes sense, actually. Bronze, rust, so it's a metals thing? No, it's by color. I'm actually a burgundy blood, but maybe this isn't the best time to talk about all this. Yeah, I'll be glad to tell you all about the blood on our planet when I'm not leaking so much of it on the ground. Wow, I really thought I'd be dead by now. Don't worry, I'm coming. As soon as I find a way past this wild beast. Maybe I can sneak past him. Pretty unlikely. What, are you the kind of alien that's invisible and silent? No. Yeah, no chance then. Maybe I can outrun him. I don't think that's a good chance either. I'm surprised he's been chasing you. That's really not like him. Well, now that you mention it, he didn't actually exactly chase me. Maybe I can give him a treat. I do have some pet treats. What's a pet? I think it would be a little weird if I described it to you given the fact that you were, it sounds like, raised by one. Let's move on. I think this might all be a misunderstanding. He's probably upset. With Dammek missing and everything that happened before you got here. I mean, they can be kind of frustrating. Lucis's, I mean. They mean well, and they try to take care of you, but they don't always know what they're doing. And it's not always easy to understand them, you know? Yeah, I have someone like that. Oh? Yeah, my babysitter. You'd love her. Her name is Exonit, haha. Well, okay, if we have an upset beast on our hands, there's really only one thing to do. Yeah? Joey Claire, amateur veterinarian, is going pro. Be right back. Haha. Okay. Here we go. Hey, yeah, now you can get down to the bedroom. Neat. Oh, this is where you were, and I didn't get to look at stuff.